Hi, this is Mark Pilling of Sulzer Chemtech, and I'm going to be taking you through our new Refinery application tool. And it's a visual tool where you can go through, look at a model of a refinery, go in, look at the different units and towers and see where Sulzer has offerings for you on the equipment and the process side. When you look at the tool, you see a generic refinery layout. You click on the enter button, and then the information buttons pop up that you can click on, the active buttons, and you can go to any one of these as you wish, go through, take a look, and look at the different sections of the refinery. Also at the bottom right in the center of the boxes, there's one called list. You can pop it up as well, and it shows you titles for these different tags on the left. And you can click on these boxes are active as well, and do the same thing as if you were clicking on one of those buttons. On this, I'm going to start out by going to the bottom center, and it's called column product portfolio. It has a distillation column with a cut open view so you can see what's inside. And then you can go through and look at the different sections of the column and look specifically at the equipment that will be in those towers that you will find. At the top will be the liquid distributor, and you click on that, and it has information on liquid distributors, what you can expect, and then a link to the web page. The units are in metric, and for the liquid flux rate, if you multiply by a factor of 0.4, you'll go from meter cubed meter squared hour to GPM per square foot. Over on the right side, we have a standard selection page for liquid distributors. Over here, you have a diagram that shows on the x-axis diameter, and on the y-axis, it shows liquid loading. Distributors that you'll be using in the refinery are kind of in the middle of this selection page. The channel distributors with a K designation and the element distributors with an E designation. But you can go in here and get a general idea or feel for what kind of distributors you'll be using in your refinery applications. Go down further and we have tray selection or tray information, and it shows the different trays that can be used in the refinery applications, the ones that are commonly used. Refining is known to have a lot of fouling issues in many of the towers, so we really focus on that with our trays, making them anti-fouling, and the same is true for packings, but for trays especially. Over on the right side here, we have high performance tray brochure at the top. Then we have the standard tray brochure at the bottom. You can click on those and look at the offerings from Sulzer that will match your specific applications in the refinery. Closing on this, we go further down. We have support and locating devices. That will be information for the supports underneath packed beds, both random and structured. You can get more information on that. Down below that is a random packing brochure. Click on that, and you'll see the different random packings that we offer, which is a wide variety. With our most advanced is the next ring packing. And you go to the right, there's a brochure on the random packings, and you will find performance information in there. Going down further, we have the structured packing section. Click on that, it shows you our structured packing offerings as well as the structured packing brochure. We go to the bottom, and this is sometimes a unique application for refineries because there's several big towers in a refinery, and that's for vapor feed inlet devices. And one thing we do have a lot of times in upstream of a pre-flash tower or at the feet of a pre-flash tower, we will use a GIRZ or GIRZ cyclone inlet device to break any foam that may be coming into that tower because that's a known foaming service. We have a lot of experience with that. We also have information on veined scoop and tutor devices from Shell Scoop and Tutor and Scoop and Tutor Plus that will put in vacuum towers and main fractionators to make sure the vapor and two-phase feed gets fed properly into those columns. And then also another option is a tangential vapor horn device. And those are very common in vacuum columns. We go to the far left at the bottom, and we have crude and main fractionators. And at the top, we go to an FCC main frac. Click on that. We have kind of a simplified PFD for an FCC main frac. Below it, which I think is very nice, we have the different devices that we'll use in the different sections of the tower. And so you have a good feel for what needs to be used in the different portions of that tower to get the best operation. Over on the right, you'll have a link that we have on many of these pages, and it's to our refining brochure. And you go in here and you'll find more details and also case stories and things like that, and examples where we've had very good success in these columns. Going down further, we'll have the coker main fractionator, similar in function to the FCC main frac. In the coker main frac, we probably spend more time talking about anti-fouling and fouling considerations, and you have the different devices that go into the coker main frac in the different sections. And over on the right, then we have the fouling brochures and things like that. Okay, and finally at the bottom, we have the atmospheric crude unit. And it's typically not called a main fractionator, but it has the same function as a main fractionator where you come in, have a very diverse feed, and then you have a lot of side draws that come out with side strippers and such and pump arounds. And on this one, we have a simplified PFD. We go overhead, and then we have also a stabilizer and a naphtha splitter. And go to the right, we have some nice documents on crude distillation and improvements in your unit here, as well as the refinery brochure. And backing out to the main section, we come over just to the right of that section, and we have tower field services. You click on that, we have two sections. We have one, which is a very nice technology that we have, which is automated weld overlay. You click on the column at the top, and you go in, and it shows a graphic of a weld overlay system inside a tower in operation, and then you click on any of the information buttons, and you have more information on the different portions of this process that go in and apply weld overlay, which is a very nice cost-effective benefit that you can add to your tower. Okay, we come to the bottom here with a trailer, and we have turnaround services. And with this, we have the trailers where we'll put equipment on your site for consignment. And that way you'll have all the hardware that you and parts that you'll need for your turnaround and make sure that you speed through your turnaround as quickly as possible. Then we'll go to the middle, the very middle of this, and we have the vacuum column. You click on that. And we have two sections here. At the very top, you go in. It's our PFD view, showing the vacuum tower and the ancillary equipment. And then also you go below, it says what equipment that we use in the towers to make them operate as successfully as possible. You go to the right and you have the refinery application brochure where you'll find more information on vacuum towers and case studies and such. And now do you go down farther and you have the VDU beyond the column. And this is a really nice case story where we went in and did a process study on a vacuum distillation unit. We ended up adding an additional fired heater, two banks actually of heat exchangers, and some other modifications on piping. And the result was we increased the yield, improved the efficiency, reduced the pressure drop inside the column, which is always important for a vacuum tower. It's more energy effective, and then we improved the run length drastically. Now we go over to the middle right, and this is the FCC gas con unit. You click on it, we have the button going further into the system. We have the PFD view that shows several columns that are involved in the gas concentration unit with the absorbers and then the distillation columns. Most of the distillation columns are going to be trade because this is a higher pressure application. Columns are going to be similar to those found in a sat gas unit. You go down further and it shows you more information on the different devices that we use in these towers. And then to the right, there's a link to the refinery brochure, which has more information. The top button in this section is the GTBTX process, which is an extractive distillation that removes aromatics from highly aromatic streams, and it allows us to provide a nice BTX product stream. You go down further and it takes you to the Sulzer GTC section, and you can get more information on the various processes here. Down below that, and it's GTBTX Plus, and this is a nice new process that we have. It's very timely in what's needed. It allows you to take the FCC gasoline stream and separate it out. And so that allows you to not have to desulfurize that stream and saves you on octane on your FCC unit. Then you take the aromatic stream out of that side stream, and then you can take it, send it to an HDS unit, and then provide a nice aromatic stream for petrochemicals. So this is a very nice process that fits in well with the refinery scene these days. So that's just a simple overview of what we're doing here with this refinery visual tool, 3D tool. We have open space in this, and we'll be adding to it. To this, we'll be adding hydrotreaters, hydrocrackers, reformers, isomerization units, utility units, probably a sour water stripper, and address that because that's a unique application. And for the refinery of the future, then we'll certainly be looking at biodiesel and renewable diesel and how those fit in and how the Sulzer can help you with those applications as well.